I really enjoy the relationships with the patients. I find it so rewarding to be able to take things we've learned from the research study and apply it to their care. My name is Allison Boyce. I'm the principal investigator of a long-standing natural history study in FDMAS. Fibrous dysplasia McCune-Albright syndrome is a rare mosaic disorder that affects the bone, skin, and endocrine systems. Most problems arise due to the bone disease, which can lead to fractures, deformity, pain, and disability. NIH and NIDCR have a long history of using rare diseases as models to better understand human biology and to figure out ways to improve human health. Sometimes there's a tendency to view these diseases we study as just like horrible enemies or dragons that we need to slay, but they actually are kind of integral part of people. So it's a complex issue. That's why we really need to focus on meeting people where they are and improving their lives. Engaging with the patient community is really essential to successfully conducting research in rare diseases. And the most important source for understanding that is the patients themselves. I've been very involved with the patient advocacy organization, the Fibrous Dysplasia McCune-Albright Syndrome Alliance, and I also frequently am involved in their events. They have conferences where they'll bring patients together and have the chance to engage with researchers and clinicians. So that's one of the most rewarding things I do. Another one of my favorite things is when I can be involved in the care of a very young child right at the time of diagnosis, kind of help shape their care as they grow and see how much better their outcomes are than a similar child would have been a few decades ago. It is really inspiring to see how some of these patients have been able to not just overcome obstacles of their disability, but actually to use their disability as a way to really shape their worldview and be kind of a more empathetic, more successful people. I think we've learned so much on this study, and it's having a huge impact in the way patients live their lives.